We come together asking the Holy Spirit to come upon you, our teachers, our administrators, and pupils and students, so that this school year may be extraordinarily blessed. As I said at the beginning of the Mass, everything is possible by the light and power of the Holy Spirit. The Catholic school is like any other school. It is a school for education. It is also a school for formation. But the adjective Catholic school makes a lot of difference. You have heard me say this, and I will not get tired of saying this, that the product of a good school is a good child, but the product of a Catholic school should be another Christ. Nothing less than that. If the product of the Catholic school should be another Christ, then the teachers in the Catholic schools should also be other Christs, because we cannot produce, we cannot give what we do not have. So being a Catholic school and being a normal, ordinary school carries with it many responsibilities. And for this year, 2023, the pandemic almost behind us, let us focus on three goals that the Catholic school should pursue. The first is IQ. And you know that from your studies, it is intelligence quotient. The intelligence of our pupils must keep on increasing for as long as they stay with us in the Catholic school. And the enemy of intelligence quotient is mediocrity. Being satisfied with the minimum, saying, this is how we have been doing it, there is nothing to improve on anymore. Intelligence quotient, our product should be people with reasonable intelligence to become productive citizens of society. But as important as intelligence quotient, and you know this from your studies also, is emotional quotient. The emotional quotient is the capacity to relate, to work in the team. Our students in the Catholic schools must know how to live in community. Our pandemic, our virtual classes, our online classes have greatly affected this. But we must restore the capacity for teamwork. We must restore the capacity to live in community. And to live in community is to be a friend. To live in community is to be humble. To live in community is to forgive and to seek forgiveness. To live in community is to be happy as the others achieve. That our reaction need not be jealousy and envy. Our reaction, seeing other people improve, should always be thanksgiving, because he is my brother, she is my sister. Emotional quotient with intelligence quotient. And these can be products of the regular college, school, or university. But the third quotient is adversity quotient. Adversity quotient is the capacity to look at difficulties as teachers. Adversity quotient is the capacity to look at problems as opportunities. Adversity quotient is the capacity to live what the Lord told us in the gospel, come follow me, carry your cross. My dear teachers, you know, looking at your own life, that the most important lessons in life we learned when we were humiliated, when we failed in the exam, when we were embarrassed in the classroom, when the parent died, when I was broken-hearted, these are painful, tearjerker events. But the most important lessons in life, we learn under adversity. Because an easy life is a bad teacher. In fact, an easy life can be very addicting, more harmful than drugs and alcohol. When we become addicted to a life of comfort and convenience, we also get stunted, tumatandang paurong. And the fourth quotient in the Catholic school is the mystery quotient, the wonder quotient. That at the end of the day, we must understand that there are things we cannot understand. At the end of the day, we must accept that there are things that science and mathematics will not be able to explain. That mathematics cannot explain 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 1. It is the mystery of the Holy Trinity. That science will not be able to explain that there is one God who created all of us. That science will not be able to explain the existence of who you are, and that is soul. Because there are more important lessons in life that only faith and mystery can teach us. And in the context of the Catholic school, that sense of mystery should be strong. That sense of mystery of God, that sense of mystery of grace, that sense of mystery of life everlasting, that sense of mystery that says, I am a soul. So this school year, I challenge you, focus on the four quotients. The first two, any normal school can do that. The last two, adversity and wonder, mystery quotient. That should be the hallmark of our Catholic education. In fact, my dear teachers, when we say adjective and noun, the noun is usually more important. But in the context of the description, Catholic school, the adjective is more important than the noun. Because the adjective Catholic gives identity to the noun. And therefore, the question to ask every now and then is, how Catholic a teacher am I? And how Catholic is our school? And how Catholic is the classroom? And how Catholic are my lessons?